Yes, I stand to speak on this legislation. It's my first time going through the big ugly process as a freshman legislator. And I don't have any rent control apartments in my district in upstate New York, but I feel for my Democratic colleagues that they didn't get enough on rent. We don't have mayoral control in the city of Buffalo, but Mayor de Blasio deserved more than a one-year extension. But there are good things in this big ugly. As an upstate senator, we got $3.1 billion in tax relief for homeowners over the next 4 years, and that's a positive thing. On the last subpart of the big ugly, subpart H, provides for $19 million in funding for coal conversion power plants that may or may not, you know, go out of existence. And that's a little known piece of the energy puzzle in New York State that has a significant impact for upstate legislators. There's a big coal-fired plant in my district in Tonawanda. There's a big one in Senator Ort's district. And we have to prepare for the eventuality that those plants may go away. We don't want them to go away, but they would be a devastating hit to the local tax base if they did. So that's a positive thing in this bill. On education, you know, we took big hits in education in the budget bill. But this big ugly does a couple of things that I'm very happy with. It releases the test questions from these private testing companies. And so children can learn from these mandatory over-testing that we engage in this state. It also requires the Commissioner of Education to do a comprehensive evaluation of standards. Both of those things are things that I've called out for in legislation, and I'm happy to see that they landed in this piece of legislation. But at the same time, where you've got good, you've got some bad. We give away $250 million to non-public schools over 2 years, and we have not fully funded the GEA. That's disappointing. So there are good things, there are bad things. I'm voting aye, but I'm disappointed that we didn't take up, you know, four things that were near and dear to my heart. We didn't do anything on the minimum wage. We did nothing on IDA reform, corporate welfare. We did nothing on paid parental leave, something that was talked about back in the budget bill. We failed to act on it. And we did no sensible reforms to the SAFE Act. And those are things that this body should have taken up in the big ugly. We had an opportunity to address those items, we did not. I'm voting aye.